Good morning and welcome to today's lesson. Today we look at development of industry. And before we look at anything else, at the end of the lesson, at least you should be able to define the meaning of industry. You should also be able to state some early sources of energy. Okay, we can look at the meaning of industry. Industry is the process of processing. It is the process of making. So that is the definition of the term industry, or the word industry. It means the process of making new products from raw materials through processing. So you make new products from raw materials. Okay, let's look at the early sources of energy. We have early sources of energy, and before we look at those early sources of energy, can we look at the definition of the term energy? Energy is the ability to do work. The ability to do work. Energy is the ability to do work. Okay, various sources of energy include wood, wind, and water. They are the story. We can talk about early sources of energy. So those are which were being used from a long time ago. We have wood, wind, and water. Okay, can we look at wood? Can we look at wood? So something you should note about wood is that it was discovered after the discovery of fire. That is by the early man. Of course, when he discovered fire is when it is also discovered wood. So it was discovered after the discovery of fire. So man started using wood after discovering fire. Okay, can we look at the uses of wood? Is the early source of energy. Uses of wood. So use number one, used to cook food. It's also used to protect humankind. Okay, those are some of the uses of wood energy. So first, the point number one, it was used to cook food. Okay, I'm actually talking about that time and also currently, but yeah, I'm referring to that time because those were the early sources of energy. So one, it was used to cook food. And then another thing, it was also used to protect humankind from wild animals. So at night they usually light bonfires, and then it scares away wild animals. And then also about tool making, it was also useful to make better tools. Remember, initially man or early man used simple tools for farming, but later when he discovered fire is when he started using fire to make better tools. And then another use also was used to Okay, it facilitated hunting. So at times they used to light fire and then it attracts some animals. Yeah, and some, okay, attracting wild animals, and then at the end of the day they get some meat. So it also facilitated hunting. And then another thing also, talk about light. It also provided light at night, because at that time there was no electricity, so they were using firewood to at least get some light at night. And then also about warmth, they're also using it to get some warmth. You'll find that they were surrounding, okay, animals to surround fire and then they get some warmth. So those are some of the uses of food energy. Okay, can we look at the advantages of food? Advantages of food. Advantage number one is that it is cheap. Yeah, even up to now, fire. Okay, let me talk about firewood. Even up to now, it's very cheap compared to other sources of energy. Another advantage also is that it's readily available. You can just go to the bush and then you come out with some firewood. So it's also readily available. And then another advantage is that it's a renewable source of energy. You'll find that people use it. Okay, it's renewable, like you can use it to make charcoal and others. So it's a renewable source of energy. It's not only used for lighting, but there are other purposes. Like you can make charcoal and then also use it to cook food, among other purposes. So those are the advantages of food energy. Okay, we look at wind. Wind. And what you should note about wind is that you know about wind. I cannot explain further. You can just look at the uses of wind. So use number one of wind. Use of wind. One, it is used to generate electricity. Two, it's used to pump water. Yeah, this is the issue of sailing ships, whereby they use wind energy to propel. And then the last one, it's also used to winnow grains. And I think when to separate that from the actual grains, you can use wind. So those are some of the uses of wind energy. Okay, we look at the advantages and the disadvantages of wind energy. So advantage number one, you should know that it is cheap. You don't have to buy wind, so it's just available. It comes at its own time and then it leaves at its own time. So it is cheap, you don't have to buy wind. And then two, so it's also readily available, especially during cold seasons or in some areas where, yeah, there's some areas also which don't have trees. So you find that there is a lot of wind. And then another advantage also, does not pollute the environment. It actually brings in fresh air, so it does not pollute the environment. You cannot compare it to other sources. Like at times fire, when you light fire, you find that there's a lot of smoke. But for wind, just okay, at most it is fresh air. Yeah, there's no pollution. So it does not pollute the environment. And then what are the disadvantages of this wind energy? Disadvantage number one, and the greatest disadvantage, is that it is unreliable, because at times there is wind and then it's also at times there is no wind. So it is not reliable. It's not reliable because you cannot rely on wind. Because at times when there is a lot of, okay, during dry seasons you find that there is no wind. Then during cold seasons you find that there is wind. So it is not reliable. Because the weather of course keeps changing. And then another disadvantage is that Sometimes it is not available at all. Like during the dry seasons, you'll find that wind energy is not available. So those are the disadvantages of wind energy. Okay, we can look at water. We can look at water as a source of energy. We can look at water. So a third source of energy is water. Okay, you know about water. So uses of water. So it was used to turn engines. And then also it was also used to turn turbines. Generate electricity. And those are some of the uses of water as a source of energy. Okay, the advantages of water, advantage number one of water is that it's cheap. It's very cheap to okay. In most places, water is cheap. And then another advantage is that it is readily available. Most of our rivers have water, so it is readily available. And then another advantage is that it does not pollute the environment. Actually, it cleans the environment. So, chances of water polluting the environment is very, very low. It does not pollute the environment because it does not even produce a lot of noise, among others. And then the disadvantages of water. Disadvantages of water as a source of energy is that it is not reliable. And this is because, or this is due to varying water levels. Like when the water levels go down, like for example, the issue of electricity, we'll find that like in our country, when the water levels go down, we experience a lot of power blackouts. Maybe because the ration, yeah, something of that sort. So water is a source of energy, it's very unreliable because of the varying water levels.